So with the magazines and the ad study, I could only find a tour that are artist tours, and within the magazine, this task was quite hard for me to find the actual images of the artists. But for this one, I did the Migos tour. The name of the album was Culture. So this advertisement was something I quite enjoyed because of mainly the name of the group is Bang in the Middle, and it's in bright red, so it catches the audience's eyes. The name of the album is directly underneath it, so we know exactly why they're having this tour. At the bottom, which is something that featured that I quite enjoyed, is the sponsors that they have. The artists are right in the middle as well, so we know who's in the Migos. For those in the audience, in their target audience that don't know who the Migos is. One other thing that I quite enjoyed about this is that the background is the home city of Atlanta, which does link to the album name Culture, because it suggests that they're representing the culture of their actual city. With this ad, I enjoyed it because the name of the album isn't the first thing that we see. We see Dream Chasers, which is the record label underneath Maybach Music with that Meat Loaf rant. This is something I enjoyed because it's right in the middle and it's in a bright colour. It's different to the other ones I've spoken about because they've all chosen a red theme, whereas this one chose a blue theme. The smoke is something I quite enjoyed in this because it does represent sort of a gloomy, dreamlike reality. Him being behind all of this in a studio is something that I might consider for my own a magazine advertisement. But personally, what really stood out for me was the main name of the tour. We do have something else that I quite liked about this advertisement is that there's not too much going on. So we can see the name of the tour. Right here we have the name of the album that he's promoting, which is Dreams and Nightmares. And then we have the sponsors and the label name at the bottom. Finally, the last one we did was August Alsina. His massive advertisement is something I enjoyed quite uniquely because we have a close-up of his face, which is something I was thinking to be for my own magazine advertisement for Young Bane. I thought this was quite unique because we have what seems to be like tears, but the name of the album that he was promoting here was Drugs. The name August Alsina is on top of the artist, so for those who don't know who it is, can read the name and then see who it is directly, was something that I quite enjoyed. One of the mock-ups that I did for Young Bay, one of the mock-ups I personally did was an image of Young Bane. I used the mid-shot. I felt like it would take up majority of the page and let the audience know who it is. I kind of like the black and white theme on it because it's contrasting. I didn't know what color font to use, but I went with black and white again because it was contrasting. I put the name, the kind of font I used, I can't remember the name, but I liked it because it wasn't normal characters. It looked a bit unique. I put the name of his symbol at the bottom, so we know exactly what song he's promoting here. I also did use the different social media platforms on the side, which is something I thought that not many artists used, but I thought this was something, a way that we could use to promote it, because his target audience are mainly teens and young adults, which are normally on Snapchat, Facebook and Twitter, which is a popular media site. The other idea I had was to have Young Bane in a plain black studio background. The line across his name is something I've really liked. Plus, it's also a form of artist It's something that Young Bane does himself normally when he's advertising his own name. So I really kind of enjoyed using the line through the name, because this is something that, as the artist does it himself, I thought it was a way to promote the artist through using his own actual forms of verse.
Done. All right, lovely.